And he said, Why camest thou down hither? With whom hast thou left those few sheep in the wilderness? I know thy pride and the naughtiness of thine heart, for thou art come down that thou mightest see battle. And David said, What have I now done? Is there not a cause? He said, What are you doing here? Don't you know that you have useless, worthless, meager little things? They always got something to say. To say, me jarau san saras tu. Me jarau san cresa satana alas tu trao cancesco. Instead of to say, Tracy Delesco, Dikau, there's a calling in your life. Instead of to say, yo soro tu sailor. Yo, Dikau, Delesco, vetare petute. There's always that someone. And who's it going to be? This was his oldest brother. It's always going to be someone close to you. It's always going to be someone whose opinion matters. It's always going to be someone who's going to be able to hurt you with those words. That's going to say, I know you. I know what you're doing. I know what you're up to. Go back. Go do your indina. Take care of those few little sheep in the field. He said specifically, those few sheep. He didn't say, Mikyara mari dadesko ksol sheep, ksol bakura. He didn't say, Mikyara mari dadesko mia bakura. He said, those few sheep. Go back and take care of the entina. What are you doing here? But what did David say to him? David said, Wutsuka dimtuka. Is there not a cause? Isn't there a reason? Supa suste traible de vlesca. Supa suste abilem kate. Supa suste penem me. Javai mudarau kakale giant. I'll kill him. There's a reason I'm doing this. He tried to defy the armies of God. He tried to defy my God. What happened that day? What happened that day? That day Goliath said, I'm going to feed your carcass to the birds. That day, Goliath said that by the gods, he would kill David. Goliath made it a battle of faith. And David said, You come to me with a spear and a shield, but I come to you in the name of the Lord. I come to you with the one thing that's more powerful than anything we have. I don't come to you with what is usual. I don't come to you with soskadyamava muhopapo, I muhodad, chavautute with sakoya, chavautute with krisa, chavautute with my habits and the way that I was taught. I'm not coming to you with a sword and with chainmail and with a helmet like the king tried to put on me, but I'm coming to you with something new. I'm coming to you with something that's never been done before. I'm coming to you with something that's proven. I'm coming to you with my slingshot. People try to say that David picked up five smooth stones because the five smooth stones was because that Goliath had four brothers. I'm sorry, but David wasn't that narrow-minded. God was trying to show us something. The fact that it was a stone meant faith. It meant Jesus Christ. The fact that it was five meant that it was the five-fold ministry, symbolic. That he came against Goliath with the foundation and the root because David is the one who Jesus would come from his seed. David is the one who Jesus would be called the Son of David, and someone would sit on his throne forever and ever. And Jesus sits on the throne of the church, and the church foundation is the fivefold ministry.
Amen.
Symbolically, Goliath is every struggle, every obstacle, every bizuk that's in your life, that it looks like that you can't overcome it. It looks like people will come to you and say, why are you trying? People will come to you and say, just give up now. People will come to you and say, just shiradogadya. He comes against the giant with faith, with Jesus, with the fivefold ministry, with growing up in the church, with understanding the Bible, with preaching God's word to that problem.
Amen.
If you're sick, the Bible says the prayer of faith shall save the sick. If you ain't got any money, the Bible says my God shall supply all your need according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus.
Yes.
If you have a problem, the word of God has the answer. It has the answer. But you have to make a decision. You see, when destiny is at your door, even when you know it, when you know your own destiny, people can be a stumbling block. But David didn't respond in weakness. He didn't get discouraged because of what his brother said to him. But instead, he pressed forward. Instead, he did what was right. But you know what happens? A lot of times we start to live this life. A lot of times the Holy Ghost will come to us and start to call us to a higher calling. To call us to live a better life. And then the doubt comes in. And then the discouragement comes in. And then you start to say things to yourself like, maybe I didn't hear God's voice. Or you say, maybe I'm not living the right life. Maybe the other people are right. Maybe I should just play it safe. Maybe I should just fit in with everybody else. How many people are there who call themselves Christians? JR said something about it earlier. But they live their everyday life no different from anybody who doesn't go to church.
Yeah.
No different from anybody who doesn't pray. No different from anybody who doesn't know the Bible. No different than anybody else who doesn't tithe. No different. And you can say to yourself, maybe I should just fit in with those guys. Maybe they're right. Maybe I'm taking this God thing too serious. Maybe they're right. Why can't I just fit in? Or you can rise to the challenge. You can have a David destiny. It's hard to be separate. It's hard to be different. It's hard to live a truly Christian life. When your friend only I call you and say, Bray, we're going to the bar, come with us. And you say, no, Bray, I don't do that kind of stuff. Shane, we're going to the casino, come with us. No, I don't live that kind of life. It's hard. It was hard for Noah and his sons. You know how long Noah preached while he was building that ark? And nobody was saved except his own children? 120 years. 120 years. Imagine if Noah would have got up one morning and said, and the boat's only half done. You know what? I'm done with this. Just when they make a little deal. We all wouldn't be here. Imagine if one of his sons would have got up one morning and said, Dati, Dihania, Sukarap, Ampurikas, Deserto Sukati, Kaipai, Naipai Katini. Imagine. Very likely none of us could have been saved. We wouldn't be here. But they stood up. They even made a song that I got a long time ago. I don't think we have it anymore. And in the song, it's people's crying out. And they're mad in the week. I thought, Noah, everybody's talking about you. Noah, come eat a little bit. Come drink a little bit. Noah, everybody's talking about you. When you live the right life. When you do what's right, people are going to talk.
That's right.
At the end of the song, the flood comes. And it goes from Noah, everybody's talking about you, to Noah!